Welcome to QuickBooks Online for Nonprofits. My name is Ufuma Ogaga. I am the owner of Goshen Bookkeeping and Consultant. I specialize in serving nonprofits by helping them to increase profitability one mission at a time. In today's tutorial, I will show you how to create a credit card expense and a check in QuickBooks Online. A couple of guidelines to keep in mind when recording an expense or a check in QuickBooks Online are: only use the expense feature to record a debit or credit card transaction in QuickBooks Online, and use the check feature to record a physical check or an ACH transaction. As a nonprofit, you are audited using the accrual accounting method to comply with GAAP rules. Therefore, you should always use the bill entry and the bill payment options with a credit card or check to record your expense transactions in QuickBooks Online. There are two ways to enter expenses in QuickBooks Online if you don't use the bill function. One way is by clicking on the Quick Create plus icon in the top right navigation bar, then select either an expense or a check under the vendor heading. The second way is by clicking on the Expenses tab at the left navigation bar, then select the drop down next to the green New Transaction button to create an expense or a check. I'll create a credit card expense first by clicking on the Quick Create icon, then select Expense. QuickBooks Online will open the Expense Entry screen. I can select an existing vendor from the list, or I can create a new one. I will select AT&T as my vendor. You have the option of choosing a check-in or savings or a credit card account from the account list. I will select MasterCard as my account on this screen. Now, everything you enter in this screen must match the bill payment receipts that you have. I will select payment date as 1/25/19, and I'm going to select my payment method as MasterCard. In the reference number field, I will enter CC-1000. I will also select without donor restrictions as my location. Since this is an expense account for a telephone bill, I am going to choose telephone as my expense account. I'll enter January telephone expense in the description field and $100 as the bill amount. I'll leave the billable box unchecked and not select any customer, and then select admin as my class. If you have billable expenses that will be invoiced to a customer or donor or grant, you need to create a product or service, then use that product or service in the item details part of this screen to record the transaction. If you have not watched my QuickBooks Online for Nonprofits Products and Services video, pause this video and go watch that video. I will repeat the description I entered above in the memo field, then attach a copy of the payment receipt in the Once everything is entered correctly, you can either click Save and Close to exit the expense entry screen, or to record another transaction. To record a check for the same vendor without using the bill payment function, you want to click on the Quick Create plus icon, then select Check. QuickBooks Online will open the check entry screen. I'll select AT&T as my vendor again and choose check-in as my account, and leave the payment date as 1/25/19. In the check field, you can enter a check number or you can check the box next to print later to print out the check. I'll just enter 71 as my check number. I'll leave the location as without donor restrictions. For category, I'm going to choose the telephone expense account. Enter description as January bill and my amount as $100. This is not a billable expense, so I will leave the billable box on check and the customer column blank. I'll select admin as my class. I'll repeat the description I entered above in the memo field, then attach a copy of the payment receipt in the attachment section. Once everything is entered correctly, I'll click save and close. To see a copy of the expense and check we just entered, click on the Expenses tab at the left navigation bar, then select Expenses. Here's the check and expense that I just entered for AT&T. Now, if you want to see them under the AT&T vendor profile, select the Vendors tab, then locate and click on AT&T. You will see the check and expense at the top here.